بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم became a prophet in Mecca, and here is the scholar talks about something important, which is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told them, قولوا لا إله إلا الله. Now, why did he say that verse, قولوا لا إله إلا الله, rather than said, آمنوا بالله? He did not, the scholar said, he did not use the word Allah. He used قولوا لا إله إلا الله. So here is a difference between إله and Allah. Even though Allah is إله, إله is Allah. He said, قولوا لا إله إلا الله. The Arabs, they have a specific definition for Allah. They do not have specific belief in إله. So from this, the scholar put down the article of faith, of aqidah, which we differentiate between Allah, Ilah, and Ar-Rabb. Allah, Ilah, and Ar-Rabb. According to the understanding of the Arabs, Allah is the one who creates. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَا خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ سُورَةُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَا خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ. So in their mind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only connected with the creation. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, understanding that problem, he did not say to the Arabs, believe in Allah. The answer would have been, we believe in Allah. You're asking us to believe in Allah. We believe in Allah. He didn't say that. He said, قولوا لا إله إلا الله. So what's the إله? What's the رب? What's Allah? Allah, from Islamic point of view, هذا قطع. Okay. Allah, from Islamic point of view, has the name that contains everything. Allah is our Rabb, is al-Ilah, is this, from Islamic point of view. From the Arab's point of view, no. That's why it was addressed this way. So we have to discuss the word al-Rabb and al-Ilah. Even though some of the scholars said, when he said, La ilaha illallah, there was negation and affirmation. Everything in Islam has to deal with those two things. Negation and affirmation. La ilah, we negate. There is no God worth of deity except Allah. So we affirm Allah. And there is no other ilah. Who do you worship? Allah. Do not worship anybody else. So always you have those two. You see, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. Again, in the Shahada, you have this negation and affirmation. So the إله, this concept of إله, the Arab reject. They did not accept. How would they not accept إله and they accept Allah? Because in their mind it's twisted. طيب. When Hussein, the father of Imran, came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was not a believer, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "Ya Hussein, kam min ilahin ta'bud?" He said, "7." He said, "Where are they?" He said, "One up there." And 6 down here. He said, if you have some problem, who do you call? He said, I call the one in the sky. You see? So this is their understanding of association with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only creator. He create and done. Logically speaking, it is not true. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or anybody, you establish a factory, you establish a company, you have the house, the building, you have the tables, you have the computer, you have the light, you have everything, you have employees, and you don't have a policy, you don't have a mission, you don't have a goal, you don't have nothing to establish, you don't have time to come in, to come out, salaries and this and that, reward and punishment, but they call it the whole entire policy. If a man cannot do that, hasha lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to create everything and then leave it like this. So he's not only a God, a Rabb, or Allah to create, he is the ilah, to put a system. So the word ilah, it has to be connected with the tashri'a. Tashri'a for you to live by. To eat, to drink, to sleep, to wake up, to get married, to live, to die, to buy, to sell, to wheel and deal, to do anything. There's a system. And that's why Islam, they chose that word Islam. What does Islam mean? In English, we translate it, it is total submission to the will of Allah. That means total submission to live by the rules and regulation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Bala man aslama wajhahu lillahi wa huwa muhsin. You have to make the slim. You have to make the slim totally. So this is one thing. Another thing is that the Arabs, I'm discussing, I'm sorry, maybe you lose me, but I'm going in a way to show you why Islam chose a certain wording. When the Prophet ﷺ was still point number one, when the Prophet ﷺ said, "Qulu la ilaha illallah," I'm trying to show you behind that saying why it was chosen and the importance of it. If you read, you have the answers in the Quran. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Qasas, ayah number 68, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. Look at this ayah which we read, but we do not pay attention to it. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. مَا كَانَ لَهُمَ الْإِخِيَارُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. It's a very interesting point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connects between two things. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ وَيَخْتَارُ. Why he chose those two together in this particular ayah 68 of Surah Al-Qasas? Because the Arab believed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يخلق, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لا يختار. How did you come to this understanding? Because we came to this understanding from what the Arab says. What did they say? They said, قالوا كفر. لولا أنزل هذا القرآن على رجل من القريتين عظيم. When the Prophet ﷺ became a prophet, those people of Mecca came and they said, why he was chosen to be the prophet? Why didn't Allah have chosen somebody big, head of tribe, or this and that, to make him the prophet? وقالوا الأولى أنزل هذا القرآن على رجل من القريتين عظيم. Is this for me? So Allah سبحانه وتعالى answered them, أهم يقسمون رحمة ربك؟ You see? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing this. أَهُمْ يَقْسِمُونَ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّهِ It says the one, نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَعِيشَتَهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَرَفَعْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَةً It's trying to teach them. It is not you. You have no right to choose. You have no right to protest. You have no right even to suggest. All of this, I hope you're with me. Am I going good? Okay. So because the Arab, they have those twisted and wrong understanding about the Rabb, the Ilah, and Allah. So everything you read in the Quran, that's why when we said, you need to think, why this ayah said this way? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated, وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ يَا عَرَبُ يَا مُشْرِكِينَ You believe Allah is al-Khaliq, you should believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He is Khaliq, He is the one who chooses. You see? So that's why قُلُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Don't, it's not only Allah, you know Allah, but Allah in your mind is only to create. قُلُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ الْإِلَهِ is the one who legislates, who's going to tell you how to live, how to wheel and deal, how to buy and sell. Allah is in control. Allah created you, we know that part, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who chooses. Since we are with this ayah, not to come back to it, or we should come back to it. So here we have three things we're going to go around. We're going to repeat in a different way. Since today is not the class, we're just sharing time until Salat al-Dhuhr. So I thought I'm going to, you know, put a few lights, which is good to enhance the mind. So we're working with three points. توحيد الربوبية توحيد الألوهية توحيد الأسماء والصفات Okay الرب is the creator وربك يخلق ما يشاء الله هو الخالق All of you know that the Arab know that the Kuffar know that even the Christian today what they said you know those three in one and they believe that Allah is the creator The Jews believe Allah, everybody believe Allah is the creator. So He is Al-Khaliq. But in that one, we have a problem, even with Muslims. Does Allah create everything? Yes. One thing, it's off of the course, which is, some people think if Allah creates everything, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create calamities, create the shirk. This is a very big misunderstanding in the mind of the Muslim. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created a shirk. لأنه Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, in Surah Zumar, الله خالق كل شيء وهو على كل شيء وكيل. From this, some people, they got the understanding, Allah خالق كل شيء. When I am you know, having calamity, having something wrong, this and that, something shir, something evil. Shir equal evil. That means Allah the creator of evil. Now, that's one way. We have the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, where the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in the hadith reported by Bayhaqi wa Ahl al-Sunnah, hadith was the same thing. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Allahu, خالق كل صانع وصنعته Allah is the creator of every maker and whatever he does. Okay? So again, from the ayah of Surah Zumar, from the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, people got the understanding that even the evil things, Allah. So some of the Christian and Billy Graham, all of you know Billy Graham. Billy Graham is like the Pope of America. He has twisted mind so much. I met him one time here in Kansas City in one of the convention, and he made the statement, and we have Muslim brother with him, and they agreed. They clapped with him. And I said, astaghfirullah. What did he say? He said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not create evil. A shaitan, the devil, creates evil. So now you made the devil is a creator. And some of our Muslims, they like that idea. And we even discussed it later. Where did they go wrong? If we said, like the Prophet ﷺ said, وَالشَّرُّ لَيْسَ إِلَيْكَ. The Prophet ﷺ in his supplication, what did he say? He said, Ya Allah, الْخَيْرُ كُلُّهُ بِيَدَيْكَ وَالشَّرُّ لَيْسَ إِلَيْكَ. So, okay. You Muslims said, الشَّرُّ لَيْسَ إِلَيْكَ. He is not the creator of evil. And when we tell you that the devil is the creator of evil, you said, A'udhu Billah. So where we go? Where you go? You go to the Quran. That means you did not understand the Quran. What did the Quran say? Here's what the Quran say. You tell me when I am 2 minutes away from the Salah, Jazakallah khair. Okay? قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. Listen to this now. مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ. Clear? قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created things. The evil things is from that creation, not from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet ﷺ said, وَالشَّرُّ لَيْسَ إِلَيْكَ. But a shar is from the one who is created. The devil is created. The devil makes shar, but he does not create shar because he himself is created. I do evil things. You see, I am created. I don't create the evil. I can do the evil. So there is a difference between a creator and a doer. This is what they don't understand. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created creation. The scorpion bites you, that's evil. The snake bites you, that's evil. From the snake, that's what she does, that she does not create. So there is a difference. The creator is Allah. Okay? And that's, when we understand this, we understand everything becomes logical. So Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, when we said La Khaliqa illa Allah, again, whenever we come to anything, we have to remember those two. Negation, affirmation. You know? Nafyun wa ithbat. Nafyun wa ithbat. La Khaliqa illa Allah. لا معبود إلا الله، لا مشرع إلا الله، لا يحب إلا الله، لا يطاع إلا الله، لا يعاقب إلا الله، لا يجازي إلا الله. Everything, negation and affirmation. So this is when it comes to Tawheed al-Rububiyyah and some of the mistakes within the mind of the Muslim and the non-Muslim about creating the evil and what's this and what's that. So that's one. So Tawheed al-Rububiyyah deals only with the creation. It's easy to understand because there's not much to dispute about. Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah is the part where we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like we said, He's the legislator and He is al-Ma'bud. Again, the understanding of ibadah, even in our mind as Muslim, is not clear. Most people, they believe that ibadah is when you put something and you prostrate to it and tarka' lahu and this. No. This is a small part of ibadah. Ibadah is everything. Like what we said last time, ibadah in the mind, ibadah in the heart, ibadah. You love. But this, when we come inshallah this morning, Qadim, if you choose or you...
The week after inshallah.
Okay, inshallah, Sister Maitza will let us know. Then we need to introduce those 4 points that most people, they do not distinguish the difference with them. What does ilah mean? And what does taghut mean? What does andad mean? What does arbab mean? And those 4 notions, 4 ideas, was cleared up in the Quran. So put them in your mind, inshallah, we'll talk about them. When we clear all those points, the idea, inshallah, will become clearer. Last point I would like to say before I close, by the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is your duty. Believe me, it is your duty to teach your children. Your passport to Jannah is believing in La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. A lot of people think that if I do salah, I do siyam, I do sadaqah, I do, this will take me to Jannah. No. As a matter of fact, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said there will be a day. يأتي زمان على أمتي أو قوم من أمتي تستخفون صلاتكم مع صلاتهم وصيامهم مع صيامكم مع صيامهم قوامون بالليل صوامون بالنهار لا يفتر لسانهم عن ذكر الله. One report said هم في النار. Second report ولئن وجدتهم لأقتلنهم قتل عاد. Third report يخرجون من الإسلام كما يخرج السهم من الرمية. Have you seen their salah, their ibadah? What's their problem? They do not understand التوحيد. They do not understand لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. We need to understand this. We need to teach it to our children. We need to make sure that when you throw them in the society, make them go out, they understand why they are Muslim and the difference between them and the other. I believe in Allah. Allah is in control of everything. La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, and all of that. So it is your responsibility. Do not wait for somebody like me or somebody else or course or the masjid. You worry about your children like you worry about them from being sick, from being this, from being that. You worry about your children from going to hellfire. كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. جزاكم الله خير وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد واخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. بارك الله فيكم وجزاكم الله خيرا.